All right, we love our next guest because she always makes Robin uncomfortable. Dr. Laura Berman is a world-renowned sex and relationship expert. Her show, In the Bedroom, can be seen on OWN.
The Oprah Network, did you see our great interview with her?
I did.
She wants to separate herself.
She won't hold it against you.
Yeah. Sure. Yeah, she hated us. They didn't ever talk to us anyway. All right, here, let's get to these questions because the people love when you're here. I'm from Anna. I'm worried about what my daughter sees in the media, like Miley Cyrus. How do I raise a sexually healthy daughter? Yeah. Well, that seems like kind of a weird question.
Well, I think a lot of parents worry about that because there's so many negative sexual images out there with their, you know, whether it's Miley Cyrus your kid looks up to or someone else in the media, the things that they're tweeting and posting and, you know, so instead of, unless you're going to put your kid in a plastic bubble, like out in the woods and never let them walk down a grocery store aisle or watch TV, you've got to use these as teachable moments. So you can't necessarily shield them from as much as you can reasonably. But then use those other things as a teachable moment, a conversation to have. Like, what do you ask their opinion? What do your friends think about that? What do you talk about this whole Miley Cyrus twerking thing? You know, let's talk about how to kind of grow up and feel like a, you know, a sexy young woman, but also do it in a way that really respects who you are as an individual.
So twerk so that you do it in a respectful way.
Right.
Then you can do it in church.
Next question.
Church twerk.
Next question from Ron. My 82-year-old grandpa wants to know if one Viagra does not work, is it okay to take two?
Sure, it's his grandpa one.
His grandpa, my neighbor. You know what, talk to your doctor is the safest thing I can say. Viagra and the drugs like it are relatively safe. You know, there are certain contraindications. You don't want to just pop two without talking to your doctor first. But some people need a higher dose. Some people, one of the other drugs like it, work better, whether it's Viagra, Cialis, or Levitra. Those are all in the same family. So the most important thing is if they ain't working, talk to your doctor. And they've also found that if your testosterone levels are low, then Viagra doesn't work as well either.
Something else to look into.
Beth says, I have some fantasies I'd like to bring into the bedroom, but I'm too shy to bring them up to my husband. Any suggestions?
You know, one of the simplest tips I can give you is to get a book about, you know, techniques and use that as a way, you know, maybe earmark some pages
Mary's
or highlight
like
with
that.
Little
Tick and,
lines.
Tick and Jane.
Yeah, right? Draw some diagrams. You know, but sometimes it's easier to say, oh, I've, you know, I saw this great book, I thought we could read it together, or there are things in there that you like, or here are some things that I would like, and you don't have to spell it out, because it's already spelled out there for you.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
What do you think,
Robin?
I don't have anything to say.
No advice?
From Veronica.
You've never wanted to make it steamier?
Yeah, Robin, why are you so quiet? You always got something to say, now you have nothing to say.
Quiet as a church mouse over there.
What's going on?
I just don't have anything to say. You just move on to Veronica. She's got an important question that she needs answered.
I'm 30 and my sex drive is gone. Is that normal for the age of 30? I blame it on me being tired from working and my kids. Could this be the reason?
Yeah, absolutely. Join the club of the 30-something-year-old woman with too much to do. Obviously, if you have kids, work, life, home, you know, there's a lot to balance. So if you're more tired, if you're more stressed, your libido is going to be lower. And then, unfortunately, your relationship can start to suffer. So then there's like a gap between you and your mate. You don't feel as emotionally close, and then you're that much less inspired to be sexual. So I am a fan of the just do it philosophy, which is even if you'd rather be, you know, watching your favorite television show or sleeping, just try to gin up the energy, even if it's not coming from a place of spontaneous desire, in order to nurture the relationship and the connection. Yeah. And then he'll feel more romantic, you'll feel good. Women will say, and Robin, maybe you've felt this way too, that once you get started.
Once the motor's running.
Yeah, once the motor's running, then you think, oh, I should do this more often.
Yeah.
You know, but it's just because you're tired. You don't feel, it's like exercising, like going to the gym.
Well, see, I can't relate then. You understand? You're going someplace I don't understand there.
And then after that, if you, that doesn't work, get rid of the kids. Put them up for adoption or whatever it is. Because whatever's blocking
and
the
make
goals,
a date. It helps to make a date that you can count on and send them to the grandparents' house.
Make a date to get rid of them.
And make a date to get rid of them once a week.
Put it in your calendar. So this is the day I'm getting rid of them in the next 3 weeks. There's great adoption agencies out
there. Mike, you've got like 6 kids on a huge span. How you doing it, man? How you chugging along with the missus?
It's called garage sale. You know, anybody want some kids? You know, little signs, some lawn chairs? Absolutely.
Right. But a healthy marriage. All right, this is from Bronwyn. What does one do who is going through menopause regarding libido?
Yeah, it's tough because when you go through menopause, your estrogen gets lower, which affects certain parts of your sexual response, and your testosterone is lower too, which affects libido. So you want to talk to your doctor and see if, you know, each person is different based on their medical and family history, what the risks are for hormone therapy, but that is a potential option you can talk to your doctor about. Get your hormone levels checked. I mean, that's the main thing, but libido, lowering libido, lack of interest in sex is really common once you move into really late 40s, even before menopause sometimes, perimenopause.
From Carol, how can I get my guy to change up the same old moves in bed without offending him?
All these women with these problems.
Yeah, Robin's got the advice on this one. Go ahead, Robin.
My mother tells me not to talk about these things. She tells me, I'm just going to defer to you. She says, I'm not supposed to discuss these things.
Yeah, and I think most women feel that way, which is why when things get a little bit stale, they don't. You just talk about it. You don't talk about it in the moment, like, this isn't working for me, you know, because everyone's a little sensitive right in the moment. You wait until another time when you're not in the bedroom and you say, hey, I've been thinking it would be really fun to try X, Y, or Z, or I loved it when we did this. Can we do that more? But not at a time when, you know, the things are very fragile, which they typically are in the bedroom.
How do you find men receive that kind of advice?
What do you guys think?
Right? Like, I don't think...
We're superstars. I don't even know what you guys are talking about.
Whatever you want is fine. Like, we don't care. I'm not going to be offended by that.
No, you're going to like it, right?
Sure, who cares?
Men love instructions. Diagrams, instructions, as long as you don't, like, aren't too bossy with it.
Yeah, just say I'm looking to mix it up a little bit.
And you're working Big Daddy Boss Man there somewhere.
And the trampoline and then some chimpanzees. I've got these chimpanzees I can loan you. They are hysterical. The noise they make.
That is your answer to everything. Chimpanzees.
Look at it. It works. Look how good I look after all these years.
Of course, we've never actually seen his wife. Thank you, Dr. Berman, for joining us. It's drlauraberman.com, where you can follow her on Twitter at Dr. Laura Berman. Thanks for being here.
Thanks.